Hello and welcome to 3D Printronics. In today's video, we will give you some quick tips and tricks about your Prusa MK3S bare upgrade. So first step is, in case if you want to move your Z axis up and down, for that just press this LCD knob for 1 to 2 seconds like this, and you will have this on screen. And when you rotate it, you can move it either up or you can also move it down. So this is for quick Z axis movement up and down. Second is, in case if you want to heat only the hot end, or if you want to heat only your heat bed, for that you can go to settings, temperature, and there you will see nozzle and bed. So in case if you want to heat only the nozzle, you will click on the nozzle and you will set its temperature, whatever temperature you want to set it to, then press it and go back to the main menu. In case if you want to heat only the bed, you will do the same, you will set the temperature and you will go back to the main menu. Third thing is PID calibration. In case you experience some fluctuation in the hot end temperature while printing, and if the fluctuation is more than 5 degrees, suppose the target temperature is 215, and if the hot end temperature is going more than 215, say it is fluctuating between 250 to 225, or on the lower side from 205 to 215, in that case you can try PID calibration. You will go on from the main screen, you will press the LCD, you will go on the calibration. From here you will go on the PID calibration. You will click on this and you will set the temperature for what temperature you want to do the PID calibration. Fourth thing is, in case if you want to check what firmware version has been installed on your machine, you can go to the, you can from the main LCD screen, you will press the LCD button, you will go to the support, and here you can see the firmware version which has been installed on your machine. Fifth thing is, to switch off the crash detection, you can go to settings and from here you can switch on or off the crash detection. From here you can also set the mesh bed leveling. Suppose if you want the 7x7 mesh bed leveling, or if you want 3x3 mesh bed leveling, that you can do from here.